Hello, welcome to another episode of Watercolor Instructions. Today I'm going to do a boat, marine, one of my favorite. If I can find the image, this one. Just bear with me for a second. Yep. Okay. This one is from artist Chen Cheng Wei. This is a Taiwanese artist. Really good quality work, and I feel as an artist who's still learning, the best way to learn is to copy the masters. You get the composition right, you understand the techniques, and then just by trying to replicate what others have done, I find a lot of lessons to be learned. So I'm always, when I get a chance, I'm copying as much as I can, and I try out my own stuff as well. So this one, it's just a boat. This is just an A4, 1/8 of a sheet. So the main subject is the boat in the front. Maybe all the way till here. So I'm going to take my time just to make sure the dimensions are correct for the boat. And so, okay. Okay. I hope you can see. So this one, there's a okay, and then maybe okay. This one is in a dry dock, so speaking, and then it says print, so I'm gonna just make sure I see. So I'm just making sure it looks clean, because that's right in the center and you want to make sure it looks all right. And there's a couple more boat in the foreground. Okay, there's some slabs or some sort of ladder. There's the main house. Okay, and this is a little bit of marina. There's a couple more boats in the dock, similar style boat. Okay. Maybe a couple of houses in the background, and there's a few more houses in the hilltop. Okay, so that's the basic layout. I'm going to add in more details as and when we go. Let me just check if we can see the lines on the video. I think you can see the lines. A bit of light wash. So I'm just picking up a little bit of cerulean blue. So very light. Kind of misty. Put in a little of emerald green. So I'm just gonna leave the house for the whites. So, making sure that I'm leaving random white. And we're gonna use a little more blue. That's way too dark. It's still dark. We'll wash. Another rough bone sienna. That's about the first layer. So nothing way too complicated. It's just something simple, and we go from here. So at this stage, I'm going to use, even though the house is white, I'm going to just make a very light shade of cream. So it's never always, it's a beige color, so it's never very white, it's just a little bit of beige cream. And okay, and for the roof, a little bit of Algerian red. Red. Okay. All right. So I'm gonna slowly add a little more detail to the roof. So this is just a background. The highlight obviously is the board itself, which will come to it. But I'm slowly adding a few more details. So okay, that's the background. So that's the sunlight focal point. So I'm using that as a focal point, and plenty of ultramarine blue. But before putting the blue, I'm going to make sure the top bit, there's a little bit of shadow left. I'm going to come in, prints, leave the white. So a little more darker. We're going to add a little bit of red. Let it bleed. and continue. So keep adding a little more color. And a little more red. Let it bleed. Okay. That's the first step, and there is another pillar here. Which I want to retain. Okay. So a lot dark. It's a shadow. Don't hesitate at this stage, so a little more crimson red. And a lot more gray. So continue to this work. A little more red, blue. I'm going to switch to some lighter color for the book. Shadow. Okay. I keep playing with darker tones. Let me just check if it's still recording. Yes, it is still recording. So continue. Okay, so I'm gonna do more, a little more dark. And continue with some grays over here. So I'm switching to some reds. Check the color, that's okay. Material red. Okay, and switch to some things going on here. So okay, so slowly, surely, add a few more details to the house. Okay. forget the windows. Okay, at this stage I'm gonna just add a little more texture. Okay. So that one is a little dry. I'm gonna complete this and then come to the boat again. So a little more details. That was a bit too dark, but that's all right. So a little more shadows. Okay. That's about it. Now let's I'm going to dry a little bit and then start adding a little more details on the side. Or maybe this doesn't need to be drying. I'm just switching to a slightly smaller brush. I picked up these calligraphy brush from Malaysia recently. They're a little bit of a treat. They got long and they hold up really well. They got long hairs and then they hold pigment. A little more dark to show that that's where the shadows are. That's it. And a little more shadow, that's the boat. Few more waves. And a little more. Okay. So that's, I'm all right with that. Start adding few more details to the captain's cabinet or so. A little perspective to make sure the windows are in the right plane. So It's a little darker, so I'm just adding some more details to the boat. So I'm just taking enough pigment and I'm adding details. So the details go something like that. Okay. Okay, so there's no messing about, just brave and one. So slowly. Okay, now a lot more blue to do. A little more dark. Okay, so I'm just adding a little more darkness and some texture. I will add a little water so that I let it bleed. Okay. So that's about all the details. I'm gonna almost finishing touches. Make it a little more dark in certain areas. So I'm going to just scratch a couple of white marks. Okay. All right. That's a simple drawing. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm gonna add a little more dark on this side. Okay. Let me draw it and then see how it looks. Okay, so I'm just looking at the light. I'm okay with the light. That one is too shiny. I'm gonna just mute that. So I want it okay. A little more dark. And that area seems to like so. I forgot about working on that area to make it more. That's fine. So, let me just check if it's in the screen. It's in the screen. I hope you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you haven't. Help me out. Till next time, keep watercoloring and bye.